Good evening, hello and welcome to our election special where we'll get you news related to elections in all five states across the country. Joining me are our reporter Saurabh Gupta from Mumbai and Mohammed Ghazali from Chandigarh. But before we come to them, we are going to go to Uttar Pradesh first because this is arguably India's biggest election before the 2024 Lok Sabha poll. So I'm going to start the Uttar Pradesh segment of these elections by first talking about the Vidhan Sabha seat that Akhilesh Yadav seems to have fixed for himself in the coming UP election. Now remember, this is going to be Akhilesh Yadav's first assembly election contest. He's been a Lok Sabha MP in the past, but this will be the first time that he's going to contest a state election. Now, which is the seat that he seems to have arrived at? Though there has been no official announcement from the Samajwadi Party, it does seem that it is the Karhal Vidhan Sabha seat in Mainpuri, in the Mainpuri district of central UP, that Akhilesh is going to contest from. I'd like to talk about why it seems that Akhilesh Yadav has chosen Karhal. Now, Karhal is a seat on which the Samajwadi Party has been winning since 1989. It was only once in 2002 that a BJP candidate won, but he later also, after the end of that term, switched over to the Samajwadi Party and then started winning the elections again as a Samajwadi Party candidate. Now, Mulayam Singh Yadav, the Samajwadi Party founder Akhilesh's father, has a connection to Karhal. He's not contested an election from there, but we are told that he studied at a local college in Karhal, and he was also a teacher there for some point of time. And it also to be noted that Karhal, the seat is just about 4 to 5 kilometers from Saifai, which is the village of the Yadav family. So in all senses, this is a Yadav family stronghold. And at the same time, by contesting from a more or less safe seat, this frees up Akhilesh for the state campaign because he is the Samajwadi Party's lead campaigner for these elections. So that is as far as Akhilesh Yadav's seat or likely seat for the upcoming state election goes. I think the other story that we need to focus on also is Akhilesh Yadav today literally thanking the BJP for what he called lessening the impact of family into the politics of the Samajwadi Party. Now, in the last 24 hours, there have been two big defections from the Yadav family, which is the Samajwadi Party family, so to say, to the BJP. Aparna Yadav, Akhilesh's sister-in-law, joined the BJP yesterday. And today, Pramod Gupta, who is Mulayam Singh Yadav's brother-in-law and a former Samajwadi Party MLA, also switched over from the Samajwadi Party to the BJP. And when he did so, he called the Samajwadi Party a party of goons. Now, Akhilesh Yadav, who is not shy to take any kind of questions these days, when he was asked about this, he actually said that, look, all of you, all in the BJP, keep on accusing the Samajwadi Party of Parivarwad or furthering family politics. And I'm thankful that they are taking away this Parivarwad from me. Why did he say this? It's interesting. This time around, Akhilesh Yadav has ensured that the presence, at least on record or in public domain, of his family when it comes to the politics and the campaign of the Samajwadi Party is much less. If you see his uncle Shivpal Yadav, he had a fallout with Shivpal when he was chief minister between 2012 and 2017. And then later, of course, he had a fallout. Shivpal went and formed a different party. Now there's a patch up between Akhilesh and Shivpal, but you don't see Shivpal Yadav on stage anymore with Akhilesh. Ram Gopal Yadav, his uncle, is a Rajya Sabha MP, but he's a backroom boy, so to say, if I can use that term. Mulayam Singh Yadav is a Samajwadi Party MP from Mainpuri, of course, but he does not take part in the day-to-day functioning of the Samajwadi Party. And Akhilesh's cousins, who are former MPs, also are not seen on stage, at least in this campaign, with Mr. Yadav, the Samajwadi Party chief. So this is what he said when he was asked a pointed question about the defections from the Samajwadi Party to the BJP.
मुझे तो ये बात समझ में नहीं आती है कि भारतीय जनता पार्टी को खुश होना चाहिए इस बात को लेकर के. भारतीय जनता पार्टी जो आरोप लगाती है परिवारवाद का, कम से कम हमारे परिवारवाद को तो खत्म कर रहे हैं वो लोग. इसके लिए उन्हें धन्यवाद देता हूं मैं.
Well, the other interesting story that came out of Uttar Pradesh today was related to the Congress that has been running a women-centric campaign in the state. Priyanka Maurya, one of those who featured on the poster of the Congress's women-centric manifesto released by Priyanka Gandhi in Lucknow, has actually quit the Congress to join the BJP. Now, why did she do that? She did that because she felt that she was not being given a ticket from the Sarojini Nagar Assembly constituency in Lucknow. Now she claims that, you know, she, because her face was used on the women manifesto of the Congress, and she was a prominent presence in all posters and banners put up by the Congress, she did deserve that ticket, but she claims that she was asked for some money. When she refused to give that money, her ticket was not considered, etc. But the BJP again using this to give her a welcome into the into their party, and Priyanka Maurya saying that, look, at the end of the day, I feel slighted. Why was my face used in these posters if at the end of the day you did not have to give me a ticket? So that's one more interesting development out of Uttar Pradesh. One more story that I want to talk about is this development today about Bhim Army Chief Chandrasekhar Azad announcing or formalizing now that he will take on Yogi Adityanath, the Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh, on the Gorakhpur Sadar seat. Now, Yogi Adityanath's candidature was announced by the BJP a few days ago, but this is the first rival who officially said that he's going to contest against Adityanath. Now, this is a headline-grabbing story for sure, but one certainly needs to look at the fact that Gorakhpur Sadar, from where Yogi Adityanath is going to contest, has been a BJP bastion for many decades. And in fact, in the last 2-3 elections, Radha Mohan Das Agarwal of the BJP was winning that seat. In fact, in the last election, he won by a margin of 60,000 plus votes. So while this is good optics for Chandrasekhar, at the same time, one wonders whether his will be the main opposition to Yogi Adityanath, because the Samajwadi Party and the Bahujan Samaj Party and the Congress have not announced their candidates as of yet. Chandrasekhar today spoke to the media, and he said two things that he has said in the past, but he said that, said it vehemently today also. One, that in the last 5 years, he spent 2.5 years in jail because of this government, the Yogi Adityanath government. There were incidents in West UP after which he was sent to jail, and he got bail after very long. And he said that the chief minister who sent me to jail, I'm not going to let that person go to the Vidhan Sabha, and that is why I'm contesting. His party does not really have too much of a locus, so to say, in Eastern UP. It's a Western UP party. They've not contested elections before. So it is a tough battle for Chandrasekhar, but he says he's willing to take it head on. Let's just listen to what he had to say.
देखिए मैं समझता हूँ रणनीति पे तो बहुत लंबे समय तक चर्चा होगी छठे फेस में चुनाव है मैं गोरखपुर भी पहुंचूंगा आप सब लोग भी वहां रहेंगे लेकिन पार्टी ने आदेश किया मैं उसका सम्मान करता हूँ मैं पिछले 5 साल भी लड़ा हूँ और अब भी लड़ूंगा मैं एकमात्र ऐसा नेता हूं जो पिछले 5 साल में जो 2.5 साल जिसने जेल काटी और इसी सरकार की वजह से काटी जिन्होंने मुझे और मेरे समाज को पूरे दलित पिछड़े आदिवासी मुस्लिम जैन बौद्ध सिख पारसी ईसाई तमाम भाइयों को जिन्होंने खून के आंसू रवाए अब उन सरकार के मुख्यमंत्री को हम किसी भी कीमत पे विधानसभा नहीं जान देंगे इसलिए उनके खिलाफ लड़ेंगे और अगर विपक्ष पे हमसे ताकतवर कोई उम्मीदवार उनके खिलाफ लड़ने को है तो वो लड़ाए या फिर खुद लड़े मेरा सभी को प्रस्ताव है वो लड़े वरना हम तो लड़ने जा रहे हैं पार्टी ने आदेश किया उसका सम्मान
From tandoori chais in Lucknow to my colleague Mohammed Ghazali in Chandigarh where I think that he is not really the most the biggest thing in demand right now I guess Ghazali
Thanks, Alok. Thanks. Poll fever is picking up in Punjab and the most anticipated decision that Aam Aadmi Party declared its CM face, Bhagwant Mann, the Sangrur and two-time MP, the party president. Now, he has been announced as a CM face. But the suspense was that from where he will be fielded in this assembly polls. And today, the party has announced that he will be contesting this elections from one of the segments from the Sangrur parliamentary seats. That is Dhuri Assembly seat from where Bhagwant Mann will be trying his luck. And not to forget that Bhagwant Mann had also contested assembly elections in 2017 against Sukhbir Badal, but he had lost from there. Now, being the CM face, being fielded from one of his safe seats, because this assembly constituency also comes under Sangrur parliamentary constituency, which Bhagwant Mann has been representing. So the party feels that after announcing a CM face not to forget to mention that it is only Aam Aadmi Party which has announced its CM candidates. Congress hasn't yet done it yet. Akali Dal says that Sukhbir Badal is their CM face, but Prakash Singh Badal's assembly seat is still vacant. The party has not announced that who will be their CM face. Now Aam Aadmi Party feels that by announcing Mann as their CM face, announcing his seat, they have an edge over other parties.
Well, from North India to the coastal state of Goa. Now, Goa, of course, has been generating political headlines for the last few days. And what we have in Goa today is of course the main sort of BJP list that's been declared for 36 seats. Now the BJP of course is in power in Goa, and many attribute that to a man called Manohar Parikar, an icon in the BJP in Goa. Now his son Utpal Parikar wanted a ticket from the Panji seat to continue his legacy, but the BJP hasn't given him that ticket. Instead, it has given it to Babush Monserrat. Now, who's Babush Monserrat? Well, he was someone who was in the Congress but then switched to the BJP and has managed to win that ticket from the BJP. And this is something that also hasn't gone down well with Utpal Parikar, who now feels that he may have to contest separately. At least he's indicated that, though he's not said anything officially. Now, obviously, the BJP has decided to give that ticket to someone else, citing that, well, just because you're someone's son, you don't automatically win a ticket. In other words, saying that family politics or parivarwad, as that word is being tossed around a lot, is not something that the party believes in. Now, Devendra Fadnavis, the former Chief Minister of Maharashtra, leader of opposition Maharashtra, is in charge of the Goa elections. And he, of course, is the one who made that comment that just because you're someone's son, you won't get the ticket. Today, of course, he sounded much more conciliatory and saying that, look, there have been other arrangements that are being worked out. They've tried to dissuade Utpal Parikar from walking out. In fact, Arvind Kejriwal, the Delhi Chief Minister, welcomed him with open arms, saying that he would get the ticket if he wanted to contest on an Aam Aadmi Party ticket and the Aam Aadmi Party candidate would step aside. Sanjay Raut of the Shiv Sena has also said that if Utpal Parikar contests from Panji, then other parties should perhaps step aside and let him win. But Utpal Parikar has so far been silent. Here's what Devendra Fadnavis said when he was asked a specific pointed question on this very issue at the press conference in New Delhi today.
Panjim mein jo sitting MLA hai, unhi ko ticket diya gaya hai. Utpal Parikar ya Parikar ji ka parivar, ye hamara parivar hai, ye hamare sare kareebi log hai. Humne Utpal Parikar ko दो और ऑप्शन दिए थे कि जहां से वो लड़ सकते हैं, उसमें से एक तो उन्होंने पहले ही मना कर दिया था, दूसरे के बारे में भी उनसे चर्चा चल रही है और हमारे हम सबको लगता है कि उन्होंने मानना चाहिए. और वैसे भी भारतीय जनता पार्टी में जो परिकर परिवार है, उस परिवार को हमेशा सम्मान ही दिया है.
Well, that was Devendra Fadnavis explaining what the BJP stand on Utpal Parikar is. But remember, the BJP has been saying that family politics is something that the party doesn't suggest. But if you look at the candidates that have been given tickets today in its list that has been declared for 36 constituencies, that tells a different story. Firstly, why is Utpal Parikar upset? Well, because Babush Monserrat has got the ticket from Panji. But it's not just Monserrat. His wife Jennifer has also gotten a ticket from the BJP. Now, of course, that may not be parivarwad, but the BJP attributes that to winnability of candidates. But in another situation, and this is even more interesting because this involves two parties and three members of one family, there is, of course, Vishwajit Rane, the current health minister of Goa. And he is contesting from Walpoi, but his wife has also gotten a ticket from the BJP. Interestingly, which seat has been given to her? Well, it's the seat his father, Pratap Singh Rane, has contested from and won for years. Now, it's a father-in-law versus daughter-in-law battle in the Purim seat. And then, of course, you have Vishwajit Rane contesting from the same family in the neighbouring seat on a BJP ticket. So again, there's two families, and it just is not limited to the BJP. There are other parties as well. For example, let's talk about the Congress. The Congress, of course, has given a ticket to Michael Lobo, who defected from the BJP and joined the party. It doesn't end there. His wife, Delilah Lobo, also gets a ticket from the COLIM seat. Let's talk about the Trinamool Congress, which is, of course, the new entrant in Goa politics. There too, you have Churchill Alemao, who defected from the NCP, I beg your pardon, and joined the Trinamool Congress. He gets a ticket from Benoli, but his daughter also gets a ticket from the Navalim seat, and that is of course a seat that was held by Luisino Falero for seven terms, who's also in the Trinamool Congress now, who was earlier in the Congress.